if I may, I have a little bit of something that she wrote that she might have.
I didn't even know you were bringing this. This is great.
I didn't know that I was bringing it either, but I was just reading it, trying to prepare, because I knew, Charlie, you'd be grilling me about Hemingway and Gellhorn, and which is great. I mean, I really love that. But this is a letter that she wrote to someone right at the time, just before that. He is a rare and wonderful type. He is a mysterious type, too, and a wise one and all sorts of things. He is a good man, which is vitally important. He is, however, bad for me, sadly enough, or maybe wrong for me is the word, and I am wrong for him. I am wondering now if it ever really worked. And then she says, it is my fault. I am the one who has changed. And she ends it by saying, we are basically two tough people, and we were born to survive. It goes on, and it's beautifully written because They were tough birds. And she was honed in battle and trained in a way by Hemingway. You see, I think we saw a little moment where he was the one who told her to get into the ring, right. Get out there and show us what you're made of. And she actually had chronicled that because she didn't know if she could write as a war correspondent. And all through the scenes.
Well, the scenes of self-doubt in the film.
Yeah, and you see the self-doubt, but then, and fortunately, we had all sorts of Martha Gellhorn interviews as she was older.
What happened to her after Hemingway died? And so she did
after that, she went from one war zone to another. She, she was so eager to, in a sense, go out and establish her own life. She wanted to travel the world and see where the action was. She was a war correspondent. Hemingway, in a way, just wanted to close off his life. We find him in the movie with Pauline, where he maybe should have stayed. His previous wife. Because he had the museum and the glory and all of that. And in a way, Martha Gellhorn lured him into action.
Join us online at charlierose.com.